going to demonstrate laboratory 4. In this lab, we're going to use gel electrophoresis to confirm the digest and the ligation from labs 2 and 3. Once I've confirmed that, I can use the plasmid with my gene of interest to transform bacteria in lab 5. Here are the reagents and the equipment that we'll be using in laboratory 4. This will be done almost exactly the same as laboratory 1.2, except that we'll be using samples that contain DNA instead of just dyes. These are the experimental and control samples from our digest in lab 2 and our ligation in lab 3. In order to get them ready for the gel electrophoresis, I'll need to add some loading dye to each sample because right now they're clear. I'll also add a little bit of water into each sample and then load each sample in a different well in the gel. I'll also be using a marker or DNA ladder. This has known size fragments in it so that we can tell on our gel what size the fragments in our samples are. Before I begin, I need to label each of the sample tubes. I'm going to label them with a GE for gel electrophoresis. So I'm going to have GEK minus, GEK plus, GEA minus, GEA plus, and a Lig tube. I need to remember that the rest of my Lig tube is going to be used in another lab, so I need to save that and not throw it out. Now I'm going to add the reagents to my tubes. I'll start by adding 4 microliters of distilled water to my GEK minus, GEK plus, GEA minus, and GEA plus tube. Then I'll add 3 microliters of distilled water to my GE Lig tube. Then I'll add 2 microliters of loading dye to each of my samples. Next, I'll add 4 microliters of each of our digest samples and 5 microliters of the Lig tube to their corresponding GE tubes. Once I'm done with the Lig tube, I'm going to store that in the freezer or refrigerator, depending on when I'm going to do lab 5. Now I'm going to centrifuge the tubes to make sure that all of the different reagents are at the bottom and are mixed together. Because I have 5 tubes and I want to balance my centrifuge, I'm going to use one of my digest sample tubes to make sure that I have an even balance in the centrifuge. I only need to spin the centrifuge for a few seconds. And then my samples are ready to be loaded in the gel. Now I'm ready to load the samples into the gel. Notice that the electrophoresis chamber is already set up. We have a gel and the buffer is already in the gel box, loaded just above the gel. It's close enough that we can plug in the gel box. And now we're ready to load our gel. Similar to what I did in lab 1.2, I'm going to load 10 microliters of each sample into its own well in the gel, this time including the DNA ladder. Remember, when you load a gel, you need to keep your arm steady. Insert the tip under the buffer, but just above the well, and only press down on the plunger to the first stop. Now I'll press on and make sure that the voltage is at 100 volts and allow the gel to run. Similar to lab 1.2, I need to watch where the yellow dye is in the gel. And once that yellow dye is about halfway to 3/4 down the gel, I'm going to turn it off because I know the DNA fragments are going to be between the small yellow dye and the much larger purple dye. Once the gel is finished running, I'm going to look at it using a blue light or a UV light. There's a stain in this gel called gel green that adheres to the DNA fragments and allows us to see them, but it's only visible with either a blue light or a UV light. After I look at the gel, I can tell if the ligation was successful. And if the ligation was successful, I can move on to doing the bacterial transformation in lab 5. Again, I'm not going to give away the results of the lab. You'll have to check with your teacher to see how you can see the results on the gels that were done in your class.